Hey, how's it going, everyone? This is the Anime Man.
Glasses version.
Welcome back to another episode of the monthly Otaku Collection, the show that I do at the end of each month or the beginning of the next month, where I give you guys an update on what has happened over on my channel, what has happened in my life, what has happened in my internet life, and also show you guys the different otaku-ish, anime-ish, manga-ish, merch-ish kind of shish. So first things first, by the time you are watching this video, I'm no longer here, in that I will most likely be in Las Vegas, where Aki lives, after I had just finished attending MomoCon in Atlanta, Georgia. Really weird to talk in this perspective because, in reality, I still have a week before I have to even leave Japan, so I'm talking as if I am like 3 weeks into the future. Very strange, I know, but just bear with me. So, I hope future Joey had a good time in Atlanta, Georgia. I hope nothing bad happened. I hope I got to see a ton of you guys over at MomoCon. And overall, I hope I had a fantastic time. You're gonna have to let me know, future Joey. But yeah, other than that, as I mentioned in the previous Monthly Otaku Collection, you guys know that I did a few pretty fucking cool collabs this month that I finally got to release and show you guys, and I hope you guys enjoyed all of them. But yeah, I guess the main topic of this episode of the Monthly Otaku Collection is the fact that I got to attend the Shonen Jump Museum in Tokyo. The reason why I will be talking about it instead of showing you guys footage is because I couldn't really show you guys any footage because they were very, very strict about filming in there. I really wanted to show you guys the stuff that they had at that museum because it was fucking cool, and it's just, it was a great experience and a great, in my case, a fantastic nostalgia trip as well. So for those of you who don't know, 2018 marks the 50th anniversary of Shonen Jump, one of the biggest and most respected manga magazines of all time. And to celebrate the 50 years, the Mori Art Gallery over in Roppongi Hills, which is smack bang in the middle of Tokyo, has decided to release three different exhibitions for Shonen Jump. The first exhibition, which has already ended, I think it was between February and April, was the 80s Museum. The one I went to between May and I think it ends on July was the 90s Museum, and then the last one that marks at the end of the year will be the 2000s Museum. Really just goes to show how much awesome stuff there was in Shonen Jump just within the last 30 years, if they have to dedicate an entire museum gallery to each decade. I said this in a previous episode of the Anime Show podcast, links to that in the description. If you haven't listened to that, go check it out. But I was a little bit bummed out that they don't have like a 70s and 60s one as well. It would have been kind of cool if, since it is the 50th anniversary, to do like five different galleries for each individual decade that makes up Shonen Jump, but I know that's a little bit difficult. And I also think as much as there were amazing manga back in the 60s and 70s on Shonen Jump, I feel a lot of people have kind of forgotten about those kinds of series. So I went to the 90s Museum, which is the second one. I'm most likely going to go to the third one, the 2000s one, because that was also another era of Shonen Jump that I very much enjoyed and grew up on, and I'm probably going to take Aki to that one later in the year. But the 90s Museum was full of stuff that I grew up on, you know, stuff like Dragon Ball, Yu Yu Hakusho, Rurouni Kenshin, Slam Dunk, JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, Eyes, just a ton of awesome, awesome series, just fantastic 90s shonen manga. It is the start of what many now consider the second golden age of manga, starting from like the mid 90s to the mid 2000s. That was the second golden age. The first golden age, I believe, was like in the 70s and 80s sometime. Not entirely sure, and I'm sure it's subjective for a lot of people, but in my mind, the 90s and 2000s were the second golden age of manga, and so there was just so many awesome exhibitions of all sorts of different 90s manga from Shonen Jump. And what I also found interesting was that it wasn't just a place to celebrate Shonen Jump, but rather there were entire rooms that were dedicated to, I guess, not only looking at the growth of Shonen Jump in the 90s, but also how the entire world of manga and the entire manga and anime industry was changing and growing in the 90s, along with the huge success of Shonen Jump. Because the mid-90s was a point where Shonen Jump really just exploded onto the scene, and I believe it was sometime in the mid to late 90s that Shonen Jump amassed 6.5 million copies worldwide overall sold, which I think marked it as the number one highest selling manga magazine of all time. And, you know, it kind of made a name for itself as it boosted itself into the 2000s. So yeah, it was just really cool. There was all sorts of amazing genga. There were some like great shows that were going on. And I really, really wish that I would have showed you guys what was in there. I only managed to take a few photos because there were some photo like places, there were like designated photo places, and everything else was like no cameras. Like you couldn't even take your phone out in that exhibition because they were very strict about it. I put some photos up on Twitter, so go check it out if you want. Like the photos you see on my Twitter are all the photos that I was able to take that day. But yeah, it was an amazing time. I'm probably gonna go to the 2000s one at the end of the year, but in the meantime, I managed to grab a few goodies at the 90s Shonen Jump store, so let's check them out. The first one I have here is the official 50th anniversary Shonen Jump Museum catalog, the volume 2 catalog. Now, I'm kind of a bit sad that I couldn't grab the volume 1 catalog because I just didn't have enough time to go to the first one. So I'm hoping I can get at least volume 2 and 3 before I go. But basically, if you missed out on going to the museum, this catalog, it basically details everything that they had at the place. They have, you know, interviews with, there you go, there's Akimoto Osamu, there's the JoJo stuff, there's some Yu Yu Hakusho, there's some Rookies, Slam Dunk, just a whole bunch of, like, awesome, like, you know, interviews with creators and the different gengas that they were showing and stuff like that. It's just a really interesting book, and I feel that, you know, I can learn a lot about the history of Shonen Jump and the history of Shonen manga, you know. I use it because I love manga, but in my case, this is also good as an educational tool. Like, as I do anime, you know, on YouTube as a full-time living, this is like my textbook. And this is cheap, too. This is like only like 35 bucks, which for a catalog that size, you'd think would be a little bit more expensive considering you can only get it at the Shonen Jump Museum. I saw the price of it, I'm like, dude, like, for a catalog, that's not bad. There's a lot of stuff in here. And, you know, as a Shonen Jump fan and, you know, as a fan of manga, your boy had to get this. So I got my hands on it, gonna be reading it because it looks super interesting. So for those of you who don't know, one of my favorite sports manga of all time is Slam Dunk. Like, Slam Dunk was not only a massive cultural phenomenon in the 90s, where, like, I think I read some kind of statistic that, like, when Slam Dunk first came out in Japan, like, the manga first came out in Japan in the 90s, the number of high school students that henceforth joined a basketball club in the school after reading Slam Dunk, like, quadrupled or something insane like that. Like, it actually caused like a cultural phenomenon, and your boy had to get some Slam Dunk merch. All right, like there was like an entire painting, like a hand-drawn painting of all the Slam Dunk characters that would have been sold for like $450 or something. Your boy didn't want to drop that much money on Slam Dunk as much as he loved it, but he did drop some money on this sweet fucking Slam Dunk mug. And if you actually look closely, it shows all the characters as well, and as you can see, it says the Jump Museum, so it is certified. Look at that. That looks super cool, doesn't it? And on the inside, there is, of course, Anzai Sensei just being like, "Akiramitara soko de shiai shuryou da yo." This shot looks amazing so far. He's like, "Oh, hello there." Every morning now, I can drink my coffee as I work, and after I finish drinking it, I can look into the eyes of Anzai Sensei and being like, "You're right, Anzai Sensei. It is game over once you give up. Never gonna give up. Thank you for your kind words." And the final thing that I got, which my good friend Xiao actually bought for me, I actually went to the Shonen Jump Museum with my friend Xiao. Link to the channel in the description. Shout out to her. She got me this. I'm gonna take it out of the package and actually hang it up on my wall because this is so beautiful. It is a painting, a canvas painting of Iori-chan from Eyes. Now, if you guys saw my previous video where I did an entire video on this manga series from Shonen Jump called Eyes, which is what I would consider one of the greatest romance manga to ever come out, and I saw this, just a beautiful picture of Eyes from, I think it's one of the covers from one of the books. I don't remember exactly which one it is, but this one is hand-painted on a canvas, on an easel, as I would say, on an easel, so I can hang it up somewhere. And it's just, look at her. So fucking cute. Like, I can't even. By the way, if you haven't seen my previous video, then I highly recommend it. It is a kind of special video to me, and it is one that I took the time to really make for you guys, and is a manga that I absolutely fucking recommend. A lot of people have forgotten, but this is another manga that made the Shonen Jump 90s era so fucking great. So, links to that in the description if you haven't checked out the video. But for now, I will gaze upon the beauty of Iori-chan every day as I read Eyes over and over again. So good. But yeah, that's basically the stuff that I got at the Shonen Jump Museum. I really wanted to get a lot more, but, you know, your boy's trying to save up that money. He can't have too much merch. And hopefully, if I do again, as I said, go at the end of the year to the third and final Shonen Jump Museum, I might be able to get my hands on some other goodies that I can only get at the museum. So I guess, look forward to that. And the last thing that I want to show you guys is a manga, another manga series. But this one was really interesting because this is a manga series that I just happened to randomly pick up. It's only one book and was actually recommended by a friend of mine. But this manga is done by one of my favorite manga authors by the name of Asano Inio, if you guys don't know. And it is his latest book. But this is really interesting in that it's basically an autobiography. It's a dramatized retelling of his life and how he got to where he is. And it is this book right here called Deraku, which is which means falling to zero, I believe. Written by the same guy who did Oyasumi Punpun, Dead Demons, Soranin, Girl on the Shore. He's done so many amazing manga. Oh, by the way, I got like the special edition, as you can see, and on the inside, I didn't even know this until I opened it up, but there is a hand-signed drawing of one of the characters from this book, Deraku, signed by Asano Inio himself. Oh, there's also a picture of Dead Demons as well. But when I saw this, I almost frothed at the mouth, because I was like, this looks so good. Now, the manga itself is not anything, I guess, too groundbreaking or special. Like, as I said, it is a retelling of his life, just told from the perspective of another character and, you know, under a completely different name. But what just struck me about this manga was just knowing the fact that it is non-fiction. It is about the author's life. And I actually confirmed this when I got to interview him live on Instagram a few weeks ago, which the video of that, I don't know if it'll be up by the time this video comes out, but if it's not, it'll eventually come out. If you're watching this in the future, it will probably be in the description. I don't know. If not, just look it up on my channel. As I was interviewing him, I actually managed to show him that I had this book, and he was really happy that I knew about this book. So that was really awesome. You know, getting to talk to the actual person and getting to see his life basically being retold in a beautiful manga. Like, Asano Inio's artwork was already captivating from the very beginning. You know, when he first started Soranin, which was his first series, you know, his art was already captivating. But the further I go to read his stuff, just the more beautiful his characters get. And it's almost haunting what he is like, and how he portrays these characters and how he portrays himself, basically. So it is a fantastic human drama, short but sweet, and that's the kind of stories that I like. And Asano Inio just manages to nail it again, man. Like, there isn't a single manga series by this man that I did not enjoy in like any regard. Like, there is no bad manga by this man, like, and that's why he's my favorite. So if you enjoyed your Yasumi Punpun, if you enjoyed your Soranin, if you enjoyed any of those like longer series that he does, like Dead Demons as well, check out Deraku. It's only one volume. I think it is out in English, not entirely sure yet, but I definitely recommend it. Oh shit. And yeah, if you can manage to get the special edition, then you can get these as well. Anyways guys, that's gonna do it for this episode. Thank you very much for tuning in to another episode of the Monthly Otaku Collection. As I said at the beginning of this video, I'm not here in Japan as you're watching this video. I am in the US right now, going to all sorts of different conventions. In fact, depending on when this video comes out, I'm not entirely sure yet. It might just be right before Akon in Dallas, which for those of you who live in the Dallas area, they'll live in the Fort Worth area, I will be a guest at. So if you're coming to Akon, then I will see you there, and I will give you guys the details on what time my panels and signings are on my Twitter, so make sure to follow me there. And for everybody else who isn't going to cons or anything like that to come and see me, I have filmed some videos in advance. I've been trying to this month, or May, I should say, I've been trying to make videos ahead of time as much as I can. So the uploads have been a little bit slower, but you guys haven't seemed to have minded, which is awesome for me. It gives me time to actually put more effort into my videos. And, you know, as much as there are a ton of people complaining about, oh, the algorithm is destroying my views and whatnot, you know, your boy isn't gonna say that, all right? Like, I'm just so done with people just complaining about the algorithm all the time, and it's always somebody else's fault if your views are shit, you know? Like, I don't know, the next couple of videos, again, as I'm filming this ahead of time, I might have had a video previously or the video before that might have done absolutely shit in views, but you know what? I'm not gonna blame the algorithm for it anymore. The algorithm has been fucking everybody in the ass for the past, you know, couple of years at this point. You know, sometimes I feel that maybe the reason why the video didn't do so well is because, I don't know, maybe your video just sucked. This year, as I mentioned in past episodes, I've been focusing on just trying to make the videos that I want to make. I'm not caring about views because you guys are still watching it, you guys are still enjoying it, and it's a great experience for me to try and actually put some time, a little bit extra time, to actually making some good edits, some good content, some different content for you guys to hopefully some of you want to see it. I don't know. But yeah, guys, don't worry. Videos will continue to come out during the summer. If it happens to switch over to a completely different background, then you'll know that, oh, this is where Joey ran out of time to make any extra videos, and now he's making them from America. So I don't know when that will be, because again, right now as I'm recording this video, I'm still preparing videos for you guys in the future. So hopefully the next video won't be one in America. Hopefully this background will still be around. But anyways, I'm rambling. Thank you very much again for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. As always, like a favorite if you enjoy, subscribe for more anime banner, and I'll see you guys next video of whatever I make. Keep watching anime. Tani!